Hello, in this video, we will set up cluster-to-cluster storage replica cross-region in Azure. I have done two-part video on cluster-to-cluster storage replica within the same region. Here, I have shown how to create each resource. I highly recommend looking at those videos if you don't know how to create resources shown in this diagram. Here, I had all my resources in the same region, West US 2. But in this demo, our two two-node clusters are in different region. We will set up the VNet to VNet connection in both direction using virtual network gateway. I will be using the first cluster from my previous demo. Let's look at the different components required for the whole setup and how they come together. We have two resource groups, SRAZ to AZ in West US 2 and SRAZ cross in West Central US. I have created two dashboards in Azure portal for the ease of explanation. My first dashboard, Azure, has my first cluster resources which are in the resource group SRAZ to AZ in West US 2 region. And the second dashboard is CrossAZ, which has second cluster resources and are in the resource group SRAZ Cross in West Central US region. Now, let's look at our availability sets. AZ to AZ AS1 and AZ cross AS. Let's first look at AZ to AZ AS1 in first region. Here I have two nodes, AZ to AZ1 and AZ to AZ2 for my first cluster. You can choose to create another availability set for your domain controller. I have my domain controller in the first availability set. Similarly, I have AZ cross AS in second region. Here, I have two nodes, AZ cross 1 and AZ cross 2 for my second cluster. Now let's look at our virtual networks AZ to AZ VNet and AZ cross VNet. Let's look at AZ to AZ VNet in first region. Here is the address space 10.3.0.0/16. We have one default subnet and one gateway subnet. This is required to create virtual network gateway. Similarly, I have AZ cross VNet in second region. Here is the address space 10.0.0.0/16. We have one default subnet and one gateway subnet. Make sure you have two network security group for each resource group in different region, AZ to AZ NSG and AZ cross NSG. And add inbound security rule for RDP. I have configured the domain controller such that it has a forest called contoso.com and an administrator called contoso-admin. The IP address of my domain controller is 10.3.0.8. Make sure virtual network DNS server are updated with that IP address. Let's look at our first virtual network DNS server, custom 10.3.0.8. Second virtual network, DNS server, custom 10.3.0.8. And my nodes are connected to the contoso.com domain and have contoso admin as administrator user. And then I logged in as contoso admin from all the nodes. Now let's look at the load balancer. AZLBR1 is an internal standard load balancer created with the static IP address for our first cluster 10.3.0.100. Let's look at the backend pools. These are the virtual machines linked to our first cluster. We have a health probe for port 59999, a load balancing rule, which allows HA ports, and has floating IP enabled. Similarly, I have another load balancer, SRLBAZ cross. Let's quickly review. Looks good. To enable storage spaces direct, we need to add disk to each of the cluster nodes. I added two managed disks to each of the cluster nodes and made my host caching read-write. To create cluster and do storage replica, install failover clustering and storage replica in all the cluster nodes. Create two clusters, let's say SRAZ C1 with nodes AZ2AZ1 and AZ2AZ2 with a static IP address 10.3.0.100. And second cluster as SRAZ cross with nodes AZ cross 1, AZ cross 2, and give it the static IP address 10.0.0.10. Enable storage spaces direct on both clusters. Create two virtual disks and volume for each cluster, one for data and another for log for storage replica. And add data disk to cluster shared volume. Now let's look at virtual network gateway. This is required to create VNet to VNet connection. Create the virtual network gateway in both groups before you create connections. Let's look at AZ to AZ VNet gateway in first region. Connections. From here, create the AZ to AZ connection of VNet to VNet type with peer AZ cross VNet gateway. You will see all the connections listed here. Provide a shared key, let's say Contoso123. Similarly, let's look at virtual network gateway in second region. Connections. From here, create the AZ cross connection of VNet to VNet type with peer AZ to AZ VNet gateway. Here also you will see all the connections listed. Provide the same shared key Contoso123. I have set up Cloud Witness for both the clusters. On each cluster node, open port 59999 for health probe. Run this command on all the cluster nodes. Instruct the cluster to listen for health probe messages on port 59999 and respond from the node that currently owns this resource. Run these commands and bring the cluster offline and online again. Do this for both the clusters. Grant SR access from node AZ to AZ1 to cluster SRAZ cross. And grant SR access from AZ cross 1 to cluster SRAZ C1. We can verify it using get SR access command. Now, let's create partnership. My source cluster is SRAZ C1 and destination is SRAZ cross. This takes couple of minutes. Once this is done, let's do get SR group. The replication status is suspended replication. Let's wait for a couple of minutes and retry. Now we see replication status as initial block copy. Let's quickly test. I have created some test load in my source cluster. Now, let's check if this is getting copied in my destination cluster. Awesome, it's working. We have successfully set up cluster-to-cluster storage replica cross-region in Azure. For more information and commandlets used in this video, go to these URLs. Thanks for watching.